This episode is all about the types of feeders that beekeepers use to deliver sugar syrup or corn syrup to honeybee colonies. Now, there are times in the honeybee colony's life that we as beekeepers may have to make up nectar or honey deficiencies that these colonies are having. For example, maybe the colony is very strong, there's an ongoing nectar flow, but the nectar flow stops and the colony is still very strong but didn't have ample resources, so we might have to step in and feed. We've got another video all about how to feed bees and why to feed bees. This video is all about what you use to administer these feeds to bee colonies. From a beekeeper's perspective, there's really four locations where you can place sugar syrup to get the bees to collect to use as a source of sugar in their hive. The first of those is outside the hive at communal group feeding locations. Now, there are a lot of commercial beekeepers who really like to put out tubs or water troughs of sugar syrup in apiaries. This is a very convenient thing to do. It allows the beekeeper to fill up one container with sugar syrup in an apiary. It really saves that beekeeper a lot of time, and they can move from apiary to apiary to apiary quickly. The downside of using this style of feeding to administer sugar water to bee colonies, really, well, there's a few of them. The first of those is it can incite robbing. When colonies within an apiary are all going to a single source to collect sugar syrup, it can cause them to rob one another. Secondly, it's a really good way to spread diseases and pests among colonies. When they're all using the same food resource, they can share these pests or pathogens that then go back with the foraging bees to their hive. Another problem is that it doesn't always get the sugar syrup to the colonies that need it. I mean, think about it from a practical perspective. The stronger colonies are able to send more bees to these central locations to collect sugar syrup, and therefore the weaker colonies are the ones that are somewhat losing out. So the pro is it's a quick, easy way to administer sugar water to a lot of colonies, but the downside is it can excite robbing, it can spread diseases and pests, and it can only get sugar syrup to those colonies that actually need it less, the stronger colonies. There are three other ways to administer sugar water directly to colonies at their hive, and those usually occur at the hive entrance, inside the hive, or on top of the hive. And I'm going to talk about a few feeder styles that you can use to administer sugar syrup in these various locations. The first of those locations occurs at the hive entrance. And so the feeders used at the hive entrance are referred to as, well, you guessed it, entrance feeders. This particular one here is called a Boardman entrance feeder. And the design is such that it fits right into the entrance of a hive. Bees can crawl into the opening of that feeder, into the center part of the feeder, and then access a jar, like this glass jar here, that has a lid with holes in it, hanging in that feeder. So as bees go into the feeder, they can go and collect the sugar water that is at those holes of this jar. The benefit of a feeder like this is that it's easy for the beekeeper to watch that sugar water level decrease steadily over time, so you know when you can come back and feed colonies. Another benefit of this particular feeder style is it's really quick and easy to administer. And the third benefit is principally you don't have to open a hive to do this. You can do it right at the entrance. But entrance feeders often attract attention from other colonies and can incite robbing. The way that you would use a Boardman entrance feeder is you would simply place that feeder between the lowermost box and the bottom board of the hive, like I have here, and then you can fill the jar with sugar water and invert that jar over the entrance of that entrance feeder, like so. The second way to administer sugar water at the hive is actually to do so in the hive. And probably the most popular way to do that is to use what we call division board feeders. These feeders will take the place of one or more frames in the nest. So for example, this is a 10-frame hive. I would take out two frames in this example, and I would take this division board feeder and place it where those two frames were removed from the hive. Let me point out a couple of different characteristics about this division board feeder that we just put in this nest. First, this is a larger division board feeder than what's been traditionally used in the past. This one holds 2 gallons of sugar syrup, while this one, the more common size, at least historically, holds 1 gallon of sugar syrup. The second issue about division board feeders is that they take the place of frames in the nest, so you have to lose a little bit of comb space in your brood chamber if you're going to use them. Another thing about division board feeders is they are prone to bees drowning in them. So manufacturers have dealt with this by placing screen mesh in the entrance to the feeder. In this particular case, it's a cone of mesh that bees can walk down into while drinking sugar water in this feeder, and they can walk back out of, and minimizing drowning deaths. Now, I will tell you, anytime you use a division board feeder, even with the best of intentions, there can be drowning that occurs in these feeders. In addition to taking up 2 frames of space like you see this 2 gallon feeder do, 1 gallon feeders take up at least 1 frame of space. And of course, you have to go into the hive to apply more sugar syrup without knowing if they finished taking it in the first place, since you can't see these from the outside. The final way to administer sugar water to honeybee colonies is through or at the lid of the hive, somewhere towards the top of the nest. One of the very common ways to do that now, especially among commercial beekeepers, is to use a lid that has a hole in it that accommodates one of these glass jars, like I showed you earlier with the entrance feeder. So this glass jar would be full of sugar syrup. It's got a lid with holes in it. And when you turn it up like this, capillary action keeps those sugar water droplets from dripping into the nest. And when you put it right in that hole, it serves a couple of purposes. Number one, you can see the sugar syrup volume go down, so you'll know when to feed them. Number two, it's really easy to just change these out. Number three, it puts it right above the head of the bees, which is a really good place to locate sugar syrup in the nest. And when you change it out, you don't really see a lot of bees here. You will see some, but it will minimize the chance of you getting stung by bees flying from this hole to get to you. One of the drawbacks of using feeders of this type is a lot of beekeepers, in their haste to fill these with sugar syrup or swap them out, will invert the jar over the hive lid, and while it's gaining that suction, it will drip, 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 drip until that suction's established. And then when you put it here, you've got a line of sugar syrup on top of the lid, which can draw attention from other bees, from other hives. And when robbing can be really bad, if the jar is sticky, it's a way to attract bees, and you'll often see a row of bees right around the lip of this jar trying to get sugar syrup. So it can incite robbing. So commercial beekeepers really do like this because it's a quick way to get sugar syrup to a lot of hives in a very short period of time. I've seen a lot of beekeepers, though, migrate from using jars on top of these types of lids to using 2 gallon buckets on top of these lids. And how that works is you can purchase these buckets from a lot of equipment manufacturers. A lot of those buckets will have some sort of device in the middle that provides bees access to the sugar syrup. Some beekeepers will just drill small holes in the bucket lid, like what the size of the holes that you would see in this jar. And then you invert the bucket like so over the entrance in this migratory lid, and bees can come up through that hole and access the sugar syrup here. The benefit of using this style of feeder is it can hold a lot of sugar syrup. This one holds 2 gallons. Another benefit is that you're administering it outside, technically, of the hive, but you're able to do that quickly and without going into the nest. One of the drawbacks that you'll see with some of these larger feeders, this particular 2 gallon bucket, is that if you give the bees more syrup than they can take quickly, it can be prone to spoilage or fermentation. So while it's a great way to give bees lots of sugar syrup at one time and not have to come back and check it maybe for a week or longer, if the colony's not strong enough to take it quickly, it can spoil. Another way to put sugar syrup on top of the bees is not to go through the lid of the hive, but rather to provide that sugar syrup in feeders that sit on top of the frames directly. There are many different styles of feeders that you can use to do this. I'm just going to show 3 for you right now. One is this feeder that has openings in the base of it, much like the small openings that you would see in these jar feeders. This feeder simply goes on top of the frames rather than on top of the hive. And of course you would say to yourself, now wait a minute, there's a lot of sunlight, etc., coming through. So many beekeepers who use this style of feeder will take a super and put around that feeder. In this particular case, this medium super does cover the top of that feeder, and then the beekeeper would replace the lid of that hive. And now they are being fed inside the nest with a large volume of sugar syrup right on top of the frames, and it's a really good way to get that food to them. The obvious drawback here, again, is you have to go into the nest to feed the bees, but sometimes that's the preferable method, especially if robbing has been incited. There are two additional hive top feeders that I want to highlight for you today. One of those is a plastic feeder that sits into a modified super. So this plastic feeder is basically a trough that you can fill with sugar syrup. It fits right in top of this modified super that's made to accommodate it, and then it goes on top of the uppermost box, just like we see in this particular example. Now, how does this system work? Well, if you take out the plastic trough, you will see that bees are able to climb up through a hole in the base of this trough, and then be able to come into the feeder. But obviously, if they were simply able to move freely in this feeder, they would run the risk of drowning. And that's why this particular manufacturer has made this lid that keeps them from accessing directly large volumes of sugar syrup so they don't drown. That lid is raised off the hole a little bit so that bees can come up, go down the lip and down the wall of this. And the wall is even terraced a little bit to provide bees a grip to hold on to while they're coming in and out of this feeder. I'm just showing you this particular type of molded hive top feeder because you can see lots of different iterations of this in your equipment supply companies. The hive top feeders I'm most familiar with from my young days of keeping bees were all wooden. Like you see with this feeder here, it is based on a very similar premise to the feeder I just showed you, but rather than having this plastic insert that goes into a specialty made super, it instead has been all put together as a single piece. You'll see this slit here. This is the slit through which bees can come up into this feeder from the lowermost boxes. The interesting feature on this feeder to keep bees from drowning is the manufacturer has made floats, a float that goes into this chamber, a float that goes into that chamber, such that when you fill this feeder with sugar syrup, the floats will come up to the top of the sugar syrup. The bees can walk through this crack, get onto those floats, and then they won't drown while they're feeding on this syrup. One of the special considerations that you have to make when you are using hive top feeders is it's best if hives are level. If your hives are tilted, it's going to affect the volume of sugar water that you're able to put into these chambers. In this particular case, this feeder can hold many gallons of sugar syrup. So it's a great way to get large volumes of sugar syrup to this hive. But on the flip side, it's also a way to cause spoilage in your sugar syrup if the bees aren't taking it fast enough. With regard to both of these designs, when you open the lid of a hive with this design, you will not get bombarded with bees because bees are trapped within this chamber accessing the sugar syrup. On the other hand, when you go this more traditional wooden route, the bees will be able to access you when you remove the lid of the hive because they will be right here at this crack and can come up and fly to you. A lot of beekeepers don't mind that. They're just simply interested in adding volume. So again, a quick summary. You will find times in your beekeeping life that you need to administer sugar syrup or liquid sugar of some type to honeybee hives. And that's usually done in the commercial setting, either through group feeding or by placing the food on top of the hive using the bucket feeders or some style of hive top feeder that I've shown you. A lot of hobbyist beekeepers are very sympathetic to these division board feeders or these entrance feeders. You'll find when you look in the equipment catalogs that there are feeders of every type to meet the style of beekeeping that you like to do. In general, you're either going to put the food at the entrance in the hive, on top of the hive, or outside of the hive. And I hope you've enjoyed this video where I've shared some of the pluses and minuses associated with using the feeders to deliver sugar syrup to honeybee colonies.